time it is.
It's time to do it with Hewett.
So in this video, I want to talk about nutrient timing. Is there really a post-workout anabolic window? I was recently at a lecture by Brad Schoenfeld, and he was talking a little bit about the meta-analysis, the research he did with Alan Aragon, in an article he wrote with Alan, talking about nutrient timing revisited. And I wanted to sort of go through the fundamentals of this lecture, because I think it would be really useful to a lot of you watching to help you become a little bit more flexible with your exercise nutrition, with your training nutrition. So let's look at some of the key points that I picked up from the lecture, because I thought it was pretty interesting as well. So let's start off by talking about insulin. Now, first of all, he made a clear distinction that insulin, unless you're taking it exogenously, injecting it, has an anti-catabolic effect, not so much of an anabolic effect, when it is naturally elevated in your body. So many people make sure that they have their post-workout and sometimes pre-workout carbohydrate intake to take advantage of the increased insulin production from those carbohydrates to help increase the uptake of other nutrients and for that anti-catabolic effect. However, Brad made it pretty clear that insulin is also elevated by consumption of whey protein. So post-workout carbohydrate intake is not necessary. The main thing is to meet your daily carbohydrate needs. So as long as your glycogen stores are being replenished and you're meeting your overall carbohydrate needs for the day, it doesn't have to be within that half hour, 45 minutes post-workout to have that anti-catabolic effect. In fact, a regular meal with some protein, fats, and carbohydrates in it can have an effect on elevating your insulin that lasts about 3 hours. So you're taking advantage of that anti-catabolic effect for about 3 hours. Now, the only time when this might be post-workout carbohydrates might be beneficial to you is if you're doing multiple workouts a day. So if you're doing a split routine where you have like a two-a-day, a workout in the morning with your compound movements and maybe some isolation work at night, or if you're doing your training and then you have some sport-specific practice in the evening, then post-workout carbohydrate intake may help you to replenish your glycogen stores a little more quickly and can help you improve performance for that second workout. Aside from that exception, as long as you're meeting your overall carbohydrate needs for the day, your glycogen stores will be fine for your next workout, like on the following day. Okay, now that we've established that timing your carbohydrate intake may not be that important, what about protein? Let's take a look at point number two. The anabolic, anti-catabolic effects of protein consumption last for about 3 to 6 hours. That means that when you have a meal with significant amounts of protein in it, you're getting the benefits of that for over 3 hours. Therefore, that would suggest that your para-workout protein consumption, or the protein that you consume around your workout, is more important than post-workout protein intake. For example, if you're eating at least every 4 hours, or about 4 times a day, spread out through the day, you're covering that protein intake every 3 to 6 hours. You're going to be automatically taking care of your nutrient timing if you're eating at least 4 times a day spread out. So you won't have to worry about getting that protein in again within that like 30-minute anabolic window, or you're gonna become catabolic, losing them gains. That takes a little bit of the pressure off as far as rushing home and getting that protein intake. Now, there was a study done, the ESMARC study, that demonstrated that those who consumed the protein within an hour post-workout had better gains, gained more muscle than those who did not. However, on further examination, when they broke this down and looked at the meta-analysis and looked at the details of the study, they realized that it wasn't so much that that group was getting that post-workout protein intake, but it was that that group had greater overall, higher protein intake over the whole day. And when they looked at overall gains, they saw that what was more important was the overall protein intake. Getting a higher overall level of protein was more important than protein timing. Now, there may be a couple of exceptions where post-workout protein intake becomes a little bit more important. For example, those who are intermittent fasting might benefit from getting their protein in within that hour post-workout. Because it's been so many hours that they haven't eaten and then they train, you want to get that protein in right away post-workout. Also, for pro bodybuilders, it could be argued that they have their nutrition and their training down pat. They're looking at elite level performance. So, like the small benefit of getting your protein, your nutrition in around your workout may make a difference for them. Whereas for the general population, it's probably not going to be noticeable at all. Also, it's worth noting that older adults And people who are in a caloric deficit, like if you're cutting, may require a little bit higher protein intake as well. So I hope you found this interesting and helpful. I'll be posting some links to references in the description section below. Post your comments and questions in the comment section down below, and I'll be coming back at you soon.
Stay strong.
McNuggets, placed with precision. Perfection.
Get the first bite here.
What is it?